So I'm not gonna say that the tricky part about working with multiple kids is there. It's not an easy task to do. When kids are not too far apart, sometimes you can overlap. So for example, if you have a kindergartner and a first grader, a preschooler and a kindergartner, with letters, one child could be your preschooler or kindergartner could be tracing letters that you wrote and learning to say them. And your first grader or your kindergartner, depending on the ages, could be trying to write those letters themselves and saying the sounds. If you have a little bit bigger gap, you could do things like, say, for a science lesson on dinosaurs, you could have your first grader, after the lesson, draw a dinosaur and then draw pictures of what that dinosaur eats. And then for your older kids, say your fifth grader or something, you could have them choose two different dinosaurs and write a paragraph about how they're the same or different. So sometimes you can take the same thing and adjust it to some extent to different levels. If there's a huge age gap for your kids, then it gets a little trickier. You might need to, especially if you have a real little one and an older one, you might have to, say in the morning, do a lot of one-on-one work with your little one, and your older ones might be doing some independent work. And then in the afternoon, maybe your younger one gets a rest time, right? Not necessarily a nap time if they don't still do that, but a rest time. And then you can have some time to work more one-on-one with the older ones. So it really depends on the gap, and I'm not gonna say that that's an easy solution, but try to get creative and how can we maybe sometimes do the same task and split it out. And when it's not possible, try to balance the schedule.